up? It's Jiggly Caliente, and you're listening to Homorazzi.
Hi, Jiggly. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good.
Excellent. So, we're just going to talk to you a little bit about your experience on RuPaul's Drag Race. So, first of all, why couldn't they have given you a Lil' Kim song last night?
God damn it. That's what I was saying.
Yeah.
Couldn't be a Lil' Kim song or a Nicki Minaj song. The turnout would have been different. Poor Willow would have been sent home. But no, they gave me a cut song. I was like, what?
As far as I'm concerned, country is just hard for anyone. So I think you did it pretty. I think you did it pretty well. So as you know, going through the season so far, what were you most proud of for yourself that you've accomplished?
Honestly, I was proud of my magazine cover because when we said make it funny, but I wanted it to be serious, so I took the serious shot, but with it, I played with words. So, like, you couldn't really see it as, like, Bow the Bottoms, Jiggly versus The Scale. You know, it was, like, something like that. I put stuff like that in, Wrestling is the New, Workout Five for Drag Queens because we did the Wrestling Challenge. But I was actually proud of it. Like, no matter what, I was proud of it. If I couldn't please them anymore, I admitted it. I was way exactly. My mom raised me right. My mom always says, don't ever lie on anything. If you made a mistake, admit to it. And that's what I did. And, you know, it didn't help my device. But it also, I'm not gonna lose my integrity for anything. And with Cece, that was shady boots. That was so shady.
See, but here's the thing. Do you think it was shady? Because she just kind of, she just kind of agreed with you. Yeah, maybe you should do this if you're confident with it. But I think they played it off as a bit shady.
Yeah, but... okay. Okay, you know, well, what she's like. We see this. We watch the show. We know what she's like. We know what she's like.
Yeah. Now, going back to the beginning of the season, walking into the workroom, who did you see as your biggest competition? Who did you know before?
I knew Milan and I knew Madame. From working with them, Madame used to make my talent, well, makes my talent mixes for my matches. Milan, I've worked with Milan before. In fact, Milan was one of the first girls who's given me a gig in New York. I knew about Kenya because of YouTube, and Fifi, I saw her compete at a pageant before against Sahara.
How did it feel going up against Milan in your lip sync?
Honestly, that was, like, I was like, oh, it was fine, but no. It was like, to the girls, I was saying that was fine. In my head, I was screaming. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh my God, what the fuck am I gonna do? I was like, this is my friend, one. Two, how do I go up against somebody who I know is going to be really talented? I go, oh my God, if she, and all I could think to my head was, please, God, let my ponytail and my bag stay on. And let all my clothes stay on. Please, nothing fall off. I was like, I could kick the shoes off. That's not going to be so much of a bad thing. But everything else has to stay on.
Yeah. So, in last night's Untucked, we kind of saw, a different side of yourself. And I believe it was what Dita said, saying she thinks you might have given up. Or was that Chad? Anyways, one of them said they think you might have given up a little bit early. Is that how, is that what happened, or?
Honestly, I don't think that I gave up, but I just think that there were a lot, and this is just from experience speaking, like, growing up, I've always, like, I bottled up, or I thought I handled what I went through as a kid already, so... In my adulthood, I never really had to talk about it. I never spoke about it again up until I got on the show.
Yeah.
So, did it stir up emotions? Did it stir up feelings back to me? Yes, it did. And I think it helped with my demise because I just had so much in my head. I wasn't crying because I was going home. I was crying because I was so frustrated that everything is coming at me all at once. And I was like, oh my God, all I want to do is just relax and breathe. And I couldn't. Honestly, I had to go see a therapist after because I needed to know why it was eating at me. And going through the motions is still a lot of pain. And it helped. The show also stirred up a lot of shit for me.
Yeah.
But it did help. A lot of it did help.
What can we expect from you in the future? Where are you going now that the show is done?
Well, there are projects that are in the works.
Awesome. Perfect. Thank you so much. You have a great day, Jiggly.
You too. Bye.